is Josie. I wanted to bring you guys another deck profile. I got second place at my locals this weekend playing Snake Eye Fire King, except it's more of a budget version compared to the other meta versions that are like $1,000. I say budget because I still have most of the Snake Eye, not the Snake Eye, Sinful Spoils package. I'm just don't have bonfires and stuff. I think my only loss was to Snake Eye Rescue Ace, and we came to get down to game three. He just had a better hand than I did. Rest of my matchups were pretty decent. Round one, I went against Goblin Bikers. Long story short, TLDR, they don't have as good a grind game as Snake Eye Fire King does. Second match, I played against Volcanic Ashen, and well, I like my cards like being destroyed, so enough said. Sorry, Vados. Round three was against the Rescue Ace player. Round four, I believe I faced a Dino player, and he bricked both games, and I didn't. But anyways, let's get into the deck profile, guys. I am playing 46 cards. Like I said, not optimal, but like I said, I am not able to afford bonfires, so I did have to find some alternative options to get around that. Let's go ahead and get into that deck profile. All right, guys, here we are with my budget Snake Eye Fire King deck profile. First off, and most importantly, three Fire King High Avatar Kirin. Most important Fire King card in the deck other than Garunix. He is Interruption, he is Destruction, he is everything for this matchup. I mean, for this deck. Instant three of. We're playing two Sacred Fire King Garunix. Normally, this deck only plays one, but like I said, I'm having to play a suboptimal list because of no bonfires. Therefore, I'm running two. Plus, it does help with the grind game to have more than one, in case they, banish one of them. Next up, we've got two Fire King Avatar Arvata. Again, most lists only play one. I'm playing two because of suboptimal list, needing to play more than one. Nice. It's a nice card. Monster Negate. Free Revive if it gets destroyed. It's also a Small World Bridge. We'll get to that later when we get to the spells. This one's pretty standard. One Legendary Fire King Ponix. It's Fire King's level one. It's summonable with one for one. It's summonable with original. It gets you to your field spell. It gets you to any Fire King field spell, period. It's recurrable every single turn as long as you actually have a way to destroy it. It's amazing. A lot of lists are not playing Barong, but like I said, again, suboptimal. It is nice to be able to have a search during the next standby phase after you pop this, though. If you don't have a great hand and you do have a way to Garunix slash a Garunix period, it is nice to be able to pop it. It is nice to be able to pop this and get yourself a Kirin on the next standby phase. Enough said. For the Sinful Spoils package monsters, aka Diabelle Star, I'm only running two because I only have two. A lot of the lists I see play three. I don't have three. It's whatever. I think she's fine at two. Do I want to try to play her at three? Maybe. Right now, I think she's fine at two. Best card in the deck. Best, one of the best cards in the deck. I'm not going to say best card in the deck because that's coming up. But one of the best cards in the deck gets you to basically any level one in your deck. Plus, she's recurrable if she goes to the graveyard during your opponent's turn. It's amazing. And then here's the best card in the deck. This is your one card combo. Snake Eye Ash lets you grab any level one fire from your deck on summon. I mean, do I really need to explain Snake Eye Ash to everybody here? It's probably the best card in Yu-Gi-Oh right now, other than SP Little Knight. It's a mandatory 3-of in the deck. Pray to God they don't hit it on the ban list. One Snake Eye Oak. I am thinking about making this a 2-of in the deck, just because there are so many times when I don't find when I there are so many times that I find myself wanting a second, or if like my first one gets banished, if my first one gets banished, like it happened to be at this during this locals, this got banished face down by a Kashtira Riseheart, and it if this gets banished, if like this is gone, you're almost, I'm not gonna say you're locked out of your Snake Eye package, but you're almost locked out of your Snake Eye package. It severely cripples it. But really good card. Most lists play one, which is fine. Possibly, personally, I think I might bump it up to two if I might. Next is one Snake Eye Poplar. Only reason I'm playing one is because I only have one right now. Which is why I play the next card, Snake Eye Birch. Free extender. If I get another Snake Eye Poplar, this is going away for the other Snake Eye Poplar. But it's not bad in and of itself. It does have the effect to summon out a Snake Eye from your deck. Excuse me, hand or deck on your opponent's turn. So it is a pseudo interruption. Like, I don't know. If I get another Poplar, it's coming out. One Flamebridge Dragon, that's pretty standard. You don't really need two unless you're playing pure. One Jet Synchron. It's okay if you want to if you play like the synchro package, but I didn't see myself going in. I didn't like go into the my synchros at all this weekend. This is probably coming out. I feel like this is a pure only card, like a pure Snake Eye only card. But it's okay if you want to if you feel like going through this formula synchron route. It does provide an extra body too. For the hand trap, the monster hand traps, we play three Ash Blossom and Joyspring. We play two Adrolla Mockbird. If you guys would like me to explain why I only play two of a lot of these, I mean, ask, feel free to ask in the comments. I will gladly explain my reasoning. Two Effect Veiler, and then two Nibiru. Nibiru is not in the side because I feel like it's way too important to main this format. With Snake Eye running rampant, there are just too many, not, it's not just Snake Eye either. It's, there are so many decks in the format right now that just spam out so many monsters. Nibiru is just too good to not main deck this format. Let's move on to the spells. For the Fire King spells, we have one Sanctuary, one Island. I did have these at two copies apiece, but I never saw myself going into second set copies, and honestly, I don't need them. Honestly, you don't need two copies of each. Sure, it hurts if they out this, but if you're not like screwed if you if they out it. One Skyburn, just because removal is nice and protection on a different turn is nice. And then one Circle because it's pseudo interruption. It can help you dodge against like Imperm and Veiler. Plus if you have a crappy like if you have an Arvada in your hand, you can just summon the Arvada and like play this and summon your Ash from graveyard and get the Arvada effect. For the Wanted engine, two Wanted. I'm only playing two because I only have two. Would definitely put this at three if I had another copy. One copy of Original Sinful Spoils. I kind of want to make this a two of. However, it's a hard once per turn and it's a hard only one per effect per turn. It is a very great card. It is great to open this card, but I don't know if putting it to two would do anything for the deck. But overall, great card. Now this one guys might not have heard of. This one is called Dramatic Snake Eye Chase. So this one, you're not gonna see this one on a lot of lists. This one you can take a Diabelle Star from basically anywhere except for your banish zone, place her in your spell trap zone as a continuous spell, and then during the end phase, it doesn't matter who's end phase, it doesn't matter which end phase. You can do it during the end phase you play this, or the end phase, any other end phase after. You can banish this from your graveyard, and then special summon a monster in your spell and trap card zone that is treated as a continuous spell. Doesn't have to be a Diabelle Star either. So you can literally play this, put the Diabelle Star in the spell trap card zone, and then use a Snake Eye effect to get rid of her. Really good in the pure build too, with Divine Temple being able to set things. Now here is why I'm playing a suboptimal number 8 of Fire King monsters and just other cards in general. I am playing two small worlds. Like I said, I don't have bonfires and I can't afford bonfires. This is probably the next best card to play. I see a lot of people playing a card like Where Art Thou, but I feel like this card is just better. Because you can literally bridge two Snake Eye Ash through basically any card in this list. All you need is a monster in hand. Granted, yeah, it's a minus 2 because you banish two of your cards face down. But actually, it's a minus 3 because you also lose the one card in your hand that Small World was taking. But still, it gets you to Ash. And that's the most important thing. Only playing two copies because 3 was too bricky. I was seeing it too much. I'm playing 2 triple tactics talent. Pretty standard. I don't have any thrust, otherwise I'd play that too. 1/1 for 1. Enough said. Everybody knows what 1/1 does. 1 call by the grave because removing stuff from the graveyard is nasty. And then for the traps, 3 Imperm, and then I play the 1 Silvera. I think everybody knows what Silvera does. It's the negate. If you have a Diabelle Star on board, and then you can banish it to negate something that's trying to respond to your Diabelle Star. That's it for the main deck. Let me get this all situated. As for the extra deck, this is something that I'm definitely going to change. Because there are a couple cards that I forgot to put in here last this weekend, and I definitely noticed not having them. First off, we have 1 Garunic Tiong. It's nice to be able to blow up the board if you need to. Other than that, you don't really see it much. I did have to go into this during the Ashened Volcanic game this weekend. And I had to manually go into this. I had to hard make it. I didn't use Sanctuary in order to win the game because I had to play in time. But it does help to be able to have this. We play the 1 Typhon because Typhon is Typhon. Absolutely nuts against Fire King. Not Fire King, Snake Eye. As for, you saw the Jet Synchron, so I am playing the Synchro package. I am playing the Formula Synchron and the Barone de Fleur. This is probably coming out. Actually, this is 100% coming out because I did not make it 1 time this weekend. It's great. It's an amazing combo. I just don't have the extra extension to make it, facilitate it. Anytime I'm going for this instead of like the normal IP princess board, it's just suboptimal. But it's good and pure. Link monsters. We have my Link 1s. We have Link Haribo and Relinquished Anima. I feel like they speak for themselves. Taking stuff is nice, and being able to stop your opponent's attacks is nice. Plus, it's a Cybers for Deco Takahitzel. Link 2s, we have IP, SP, Hita. One card that I did not put in that I thought that I did, that I forgot about, which I absolutely needed this weekend, was Dark. I'm mad at myself because I didn't put Dark in. And then 1 Sunlight Wolf, just because grind game. Link 3s, I have a Princess, and a Heat Soul. At the time of the tournament, I only had one. That's why I only played one. But since then, I have picked up another one, and it is definitely going in the deck. Honestly, the changes are probably just going to be Formula and Barone swap out for Princess and Dark, honestly. And then my Link Fours, Apo, Zelantis, and Amblowale. No Raging Phoenix because that card's expensive as well. That's it for the extra deck. Let me see. Here is my side deck. Side deck, like I said earlier in the video, if you guys would like me to explain my reasoning behind playing two ofs for most of my car most of my staples instead of three ofs, I will gladly explain that to you. I'm just not gonna do it right here because that it takes a while to explain. As for the monsters in my side deck, I have two Artifact Lancia, just because my getting my stuff vanished really sucks. Ghost Spells, because A, getting my stuff vanished really sucks, and B, them summoning from the graveyard really sucks. Same with DD Crow. Nice to be able to move stuff from their graveyard. And again, getting your stuff banished really sucks. That's why it's good against your opponent. As for the spells, we play One Soul Release. Again, getting your stuff banished sucks, so it's good. Two Crossout Designator because hand traps really suck to have played against you. As for the traps, we are playing two Anti-Spell Fragrance, two Summon Limit. And then, last but not least, we're playing two evenly matched. Anti-Spell Fragrance just completely kills the kills the mirror match going for, if you go first. Like, I played this against the Rescue Ace player game two. I flipped this and he automatically scooped. We went to game three. Like I said, game three was I just had a be he just had a better hand than I did. Summon Limits is almost the same way. It really stops them in their tracks. Plus, you can get rid of this with like Diabelle Star and your Snake Eye stuff and original if you haven't summoned twice already. It's really nice. And then evenly matched is just evenly matched. Everybody knows evenly matched. Everybody knows what it does. Everybody knows why it's good. Banishing stuff is fun. That about concludes it, though, guys. If you guys have any questions, comments, complaints, let me know in the comments section down below. I'm gonna try to keep pumping these out. Not these specifically, deck profiles. I'm gonna try to pump out some content more frequently. I know I keep saying that I'm gonna pump out content frequently from here on out, and basically all my videos, and I just don't follow up with it. So me saying it now is probably means nothing to you guys. But I'm not gonna say I promise, but I will just say I will be putting out more content from here on out. Until next time, guys, see ya.